And now, the Bonfire with Big J. Oakerson and Dan Soder.
Yep. Well, we're coming to you live from the comedy office because Jerk Off Jacob forgot to book us a studio.
I swear to God, I hope he's getting eaten in Florida right now by a shark.
I hope he loses a leg.
What's that?
I hope he's in a gator fight.
Oh,
right
that'd
now.
Be awesome. They go, no, let the gator have him.
Just the gator roll?
This Jew gonna get chewed on up by a gator.
It's the Bonfire. Comedy Central Radio, Sirius XM 95. I'm Big J. Oakerson. That handsome voice is Dan Soder.
Oh, hey, dude.
No, Jacob. Jacob left and fucking shoved it right up our ass.
As I said right before the show starts, when the mouse is away, the cats will play. Let's go through his stuff.
Oh, does he have stuff?
Yeah. So let's go through his desk.
What if it's just like a bar, like cat heads and shit?
Oh, doll eyes? Just a whole jar of doll eyes? And you're like, Jacob, what is that? He goes, it gives me feelings.
He's got a bunch of failed experiment naked women in his attic or something.
Yeah.
Don't go to Astoria.
I heard you live by yourself, but I didn't know it was like that.
No, it's they all love me.
I'm going to bring them back to life.
I feed them Wendy's and McDonald's.
Too many fucking faggots in this city.
Oh, dude.
Wow.
That episode hasn't played yet. So that out of context is real harsh. Oh,
fucking pussy. Fucking faggot. I love Christine and I bake.
Angry Jacob. God damn it, Lou.
I love Christine and I bake.
What a perfect...
I love Christine and I bake.
Oh, and then Christine, I'm good at Shakespeare. That's if Christine left the show. If Jacob and Christine ran away together.
That is really out of context.
Also, Angry Jacob just sounds funny.
Yeah, oh yeah.
It's just great finding out that, like, if he has... Like, when he just texted us, he's like, hey, have a good show, homos. And you're like, shut up, Jacob.
Is that your own?
Too many fucking faggots in this city.
But that's new. This is new Jacob.
Jesus. That's a shot of fucking stiff whiskey right there.
I'm the only guy who could fuck this girl. Everyone's a fucking faggot.
Lou, you were up late last night.
God damn. Were you drunk in front of a keyboard with noisemakers? Go, that's almost dead. I almost got him. Dude, that is... We did that yesterday, right?
Yesterday.
Oh, dude. And that show hasn't aired. That's going to be one of the Bonfire Lost tapes.
I mean, that's great, Lou. I didn't realize he said such harsh things.
You isolate that audio. And, oh, boy. That's a HR fucking nightmare. Speaking of HR nightmares, we might as well bring it up. Opie got fired today, and no one in this building's talking about it, which is odd.
Is it official?
I don't know. We read
allegedly.
Allegedly, it's official, right? It's official. And what's your name again?
Dan.
Oh,
fucking weirdo.
I don't know how I remember that.
It's the only way I remembered it.
Figuring out the weed pipes. Weed pen. Dan, you work at Sirius, right?
Right. Yeah.
And you're filling in for Black Lou and Jacob.
That's both of them.
Okay. So, but you work here at Sirius, and have you heard what the reason is?
Why? Yeah, there was a statement on this website, allaccess.com.
Yeah.
From the company, apparently, that OP's been terminated.
Louis J. Gomez walking in the studio.
Go sit down, stupid.
And your trash skateboard.
It's called a penny board, bitch.
Where did you find it?
In the trash.
Yeah, you found it in the garbage.
Okay, that's not the adjective I would use to describe it first. I would say your tiny skateboard. Your fun skateboard.
No, you have a tiny skateboard that you found in the garbage. It's your penny board. It's your garbage board.
Yeah.
Wow. Do you know how to skateboard, Dan?
Not at all.
I can't even get on one.
But Lewis is very good at rollerblading, skateboarding.
No, I'm very good with whatever the sense of, like, you know, hand eye
balance,
not hand eye coordination. Like I can juggle and I can do magic tricks and I can fidget spin and do tricks with that. I'm not coordinated. I can't play basketball. You know what I'm saying? But I can do those. I don't know what that is.
I know what you mean. You can do stuff like skateboard, rollerblade, fidget spin, but
magic.
Not.
Lewis is also the master.
I can do sleight of hand magic. My finger's inside of Christine right now.
This is really hard for us to sell you, is it, to anybody, when you're like, I do all the awesome stuff. I do this. I rollerblade fast down the street when you're walking across the street. I fidget spin. I do slide.
Jump walls.
I make you watch. Yeah, I parkour. I make you watch my magic.
Parkour. I got up here on the outside of the building.
Also, oh, sweet, trash skateboard. Dude, that's a great find. In the
I found my base jumping parachute out back of a Wendy's.
Who threw out this perfectly good parachute? Let me get off this top of this building.
No, listen, I'll tell you what. There's always something about me from when I was a little kid where I always wanted to do whatever the alternative thing was.
So alt.
I just was like.
I liked this story. When I read it in the Cyndi Lauper's autobiography.
I was always so unusual.
I like to wear my hair different and the people in Queens didn't like it.
The kids all said I was so unusual.
Lewis goes, I want to do everything different. What do you guys have, parents? I don't want those. I don't want a childhood.
I'm alt. I'm the first alt comic.
Yeah.
Alternative parents.
No, but I saw you writing it. I mean, you're like good at writing it. You can write it places comfortably. You can write it.
I get around. I've cut my travel time in half and I have not spent money on a taxi in like a month.
You got to sell Legion of Skanks.
Penny boards.
Yeah, right?
Dope.
Why don't you bring me on board?
Don't buy
the gas
me up,
digital
bro.
Fucking marketing department.
Yeah, you're kind of the enemy. This whole bonfire thing. Anyway, so Opie got fired, huh? That's fun.
That's you walked in right as we were talking about it.
I know. I saw you guys talking about it.
How did you see us talking? You were watching our mouths?
Yeah. I've been practicing my lip reading. I've been fidget spinning, yo-yoing, and practicing lip reading.
Lewis is down the hallway going, not yet. Wait.
Okay, I'm gonna walk the dog over to it. Oh, hey guys. Oh, what are you guys talking about? Opie, I was just out here walking the dog.
I saw your lips moving.
Yeah, I saw you mouth Opie. So we're trying to figure out what on Variety. Now there's something up.
It's on Variety. It's to the day, right? Or almost to the day that Anthony got fired?
No.
Almost 3 years to the day that when Anthony got fired, July 4th weekend, for taking a picture of somebody without their permission, it is the fucking, they're the same dude.
I'll tell you this, it's genius if he planned it.
What, if he planned getting fired?
Yeah, if he did that. If he's like, let me get
fired. What do you think's going to happen? He's going over.
It is genius. He gave up his kids' college fund. He really gave that up.
The millions that they have already.
You think this is a plan to go over and do Opie and Anthony on Kumia Network?
I don't know.
I think they'll probably do it. Yeah. I know that Anthony is like, they're making a hard play for it. They have been for a while. It seems like this has been happening for a while, though. Like, his whole staff has hated him for a while. The rumblings behind Opie's back here at Sirius
XM. So you've heard it.
I've heard shit for a while. I said this on Jim's show last week. It's like, I was told not to ever shit on Opie by multiple people at SiriusXM that he would specifically try to get you fired from your gigs if you ever made jokes about him. He never brought me and Dave on those shows specifically. I was told by Bobby Kelly and other people, he was like, oh, he doesn't like you. You joked about him on Anthony's show, so now he never wants to fucking help you guys.
That's all right. That's weird. I didn't have that kind of relationship with Opie. Like Opie and Anthony were both cool to me.
Yeah.
But you said that like you heard that if you talk shit about it, because we used to make fun of the fact that we were in his broom closet.
Yeah.
And that he banished us.
He bullied us out of the off studio.
But we never got any flack for that shit.
I don't know. I mean,
was that what happened? That he just put a show on immediately that competed with ours time wise?
Yeah, but then it didn't work and we're still here.
Yeah, no,
he would do a little passive aggressive bitch things. Instead of just saying how you fucking feel, he'll take your studio away or he'll put your friends on against you in the same time slot. You're like, dude, what are you
was
doing?
Was that when Monday and Tuesday was
stupid? This would have fucking
shit. Yeah,
shitty...
put it up right against, Skanks.
Yeah. Tuesday, but then also with,
on a Monday?
Race Wars as well.
Yeah, they put Race Wars right
now. So it's like, you understand, this is why you're an idiot, okay? Because you have people that have the same fan bases that can all share fan bases and kind of jump back and forth. Why would you have them kind of compete against each other? Also, we're gonna win. We're Legion of fucking Skanks.
Yeah, you're an army.
Crazy?
Goddamn
motherfucker.
Race Wars, try to compete with us? Get the fuck out of here, bitch.
Ooh, this is some real Macho Man Hulk Hogan breakup right here. Mega powers.
We're all about finding, villains now and arch nemeses because, we were told yesterday in studio here, actually at Sirius, that TJ Miller was up here telling everyone that I'm the worst person.
He made you look like a bitch on the show last night.
We obliterated him on the show last night.
Oh, there's a video of it. Do you see the video? It's out.
Of what? Wait, yeah. I want to know what's going on with it.
Pull it up. It's out on YouTube. They put the TJ Miller versus Legion of Skanks.
TJ Miller said he's been going around telling everybody I'm the worst person in comedy. Like, not comedian.
You're like, how do you know being? Jay that well?
I think he nailed it, but I think from like a distance.
Like shot in the dark.
It's like when someone throws those videos of them throwing basketballs off patios and hitting it on a boat. You're like, I mean, you nailed. Wait, this is
last night on Legion of Skanks. He happened to be in the house.
I mean, we can't watch a 10-minute clip.
Ladies and gentlemen, the great TJ Miller joins Legion of Skanks.
Hi, TJ.
Get him a chair. Get him a chair and a fucking mic.
We have four interns competing.
I hate
that really
richness.
Is. I can already see from the jewelry.
There's no chair for TJ Miller. How is it possible?
I hate how rich he is. He's so rich. I
look nervous for some reason. Before anything happens.
The requirement for the job is to always be ready for TJ Miller to show up at any minute.
There is
we
nothing.
Told
so
you
this
that.
Happened. This is fresh off.
My
oh, wow. It is TJ.
Hello.
I was totally expecting you guys to have Omar or someone dress up.
No, TJ.
I have to go because I'm going to go and play pinball, and I'm betting a lot of money. I have a lot
is
of money.
Is this the movie Accused?
And,
we have to go rape a chick on a pinball machine.
I've only been on the show one other time,
right.
And I'll never go on it again.
I don't blame you. I don't blame you.
What show?
This is the last time.
This is the best place to announce that.
My big... It's one of the only places to announce it. So my biggest thing though now is... That I've decided that Big J. Okerson
right.
is the my villain in the city.
Ah, oh. He's your Newman.
Because
your Newman.
I like villains. Like yeah. Michael Showalter is a big villain.
Yeah,
Jay, if you were funny, you would punch him in the temple right now.
Right. No, he probably funny. Still will.
So that's the new thing. You guys are going to create villains.
Jay's TJ's villain.
I'm his villain. He told me so.
But then it got so good. We had Mike, who's here right now, Harrington, who was competing in the Intern Olympics.
Yeah,
pretty great.
We first of all, the interns were going to jump TJ Miller. They were ready to beat the shit.
I think
we'd have to stop him.
If you put Alex, the tiny one, up, she was going to scratch his fucking eyeballs out.
Oh, man, that's awesome.
It was going to be a team.
Those are like the boys.
So, but what Mike actually did was he goes out and TJ's playing pinball, and Mike unplugged his pinball machine while he was playing it.
It was pretty awesome.
Can I just tell you right now?
While we all sang a song... about T.J. Miller being a cunt.
To the beat of
that's
a
Night Court.
That's an... Are you guys bringing Night Court back when I'm not there? That's kind of fucked up.
Yeah, well, we also created lyrics that T.J. Miller's a cunt, too.
Okay. God damn it, that sounds so much fun.
T.J. Miller is a cunt. What a cunt.
Yeah, that's a good bully move, unplugging anyone's video game.
Oh, dude.
Yeah. I'll tell you this. I think you guys have always been poised to turn heel, Legion of Skanks.
We've never been the good guys.
No, but that's what I'm saying. But now you can do, but I'm saying.
We were touting rape culture, racism, Lewis. Sexism.
But I'm saying now you can go full heel. You were kind of like Stone Cold, where people kind of liked you, guy.
Yeah.
Like, oh, is he gonna
be like Sergeant Slaughter when he joined?
Middle East Sergeant Slaughter.
Nobody was on his side.
Dude, if you had one friend that went with Sergeant Slaughter, you're like, are you getting beat at home? why would you?
Like, they created the ultimate heel.
Yeah.
He was
an army sergeant that went to Iraq. By the way, not even in during
Iraq's first war.
The one where they just got their shit pushed in. It's not like even when they were fighting back, like with ISIS and shit. You know, like Iraq, they're the second Iraq war, you're like, they did a lot. They did some damage.
Yeah.
First one, you're like, yeah, we rolled them
35. We just went and mowed down a country.
Dude, yeah, so if you got on board with Sergeant Slaughter.
That's incredible. Like, dude, Vince McMahon's like, I got it.
Yeah.
I have the greatest idea ever. We are going to literally create an actual villain.
I mean, they did the perfect job of making it. Like, no one liked it. Yeah, plus he was like sloppy. His belly was over it. And he was like an older, that was a great villain.
Even the guys who liked, like, the bad guys in wrestling were like, that's just too far.
Yeah, Ric Flair fans are like, I mean, that's just disrespectful.
Come on. Fucking,
we're
dying, you know?
I got a cousin.
Comes out holding the heads of citizens.
stupid slugs. Look at this. I don't have the head of a child. You're like,
they really had him pulling heel. Like, Sergeant Slaughter was like giving, like, you know, he was endorsing, like, kids' cereals and all kinds of shit.
Liz Sets Fire is saying, I'm absolutely tickled that Luis Che Gomez has a job with Sirius and Opie doesn't.
It's funny. We're taking him out one at a time.
Wow.
Who's next on our hit
list? I'll tell you this. Typical, he lived up to the name. That's a rattlesnake. Yeah. You just lay in the grass and you're like, oh, fuck.
Look, who knows? I believe in things like chaos theory, the butterfly effect. You know, if Opie would have
anything
had,
with Ashton Kutcher, really.
Yeah. If he's in a soggy, wet t-shirt looking sick.
I really do love Ashton Kutcher projects. I like the Steve Jobs movie.
The one he was in?
No, I didn't like that one, but I kind of liked it.
You like that one over the Fassbender?
No, Fassbender one was incredible.
Yeah, come on.
Come on, bro. That convinced me to read the book.
Yeah.
Anyway,
I
believe that if Opie would have had me and Dave Smith on a show, if he would have invited me and Dave in.
You could have saved his career.
Who knows where he would be right
you
now?
You think that...
Different trajectory, different reality.
All right, now I think about that all the time because I was supposed to call my sister the week she was killed in a car accident. Yeah. So I constantly think, like, if I would have called her, would that changed?
She would have still died, but Opie would still be on air.
That's what I thought. Yeah. That's what I thought. So if I would have called her...
She would have died on that call,
yeah.
Actually.
Yeah, she would have been like,
hi, Dan. Just flipped
off of. Hey, probably shouldn't answer my phone here, but...
Bend over end, and I'm going like this. Hello? She goes,
ah, the
I'm
radio!
Trapped. I'm trapped! I'm
yeah,
trapped
in just, fire! Dan, it's okay, I'm still alive.
She goes, oh no, the seatbelt is caught. I can't.
I think it's gas is dripping.
I can't.
Is engine fire?
Fast forward 17 years, it's Jay and Opie.
Thriving.
Yeah, I got a needle problem in Aurora. I'm just on the fucking 225 underpass. Like, hey, I'll fight anybody for a fix.
Final destination.
Like, I would have killed her faster.
I would have killed her faster. You should have just died a couple exits earlier on the I-10.
You saved Opie's career.
But, Opie, all right, but yeah. Opie's still going strong. Me and shit. Him, oh, we're 10 years into our thing.
Yeah.
So funny.
You guys are riffing.
I gotta run. Listen, I wanna, Steven in Virginia, you're the fucking man. Love you.
I gotta bounce. Culture.
Love you guys. Real S Podcast, Legion of Skanks, believe you me.
At Louis J. Gomez.
At Louis J. Gomez. Gomez Comedy on Instagram. GomezComedy.com for my dates and all that other shit.
He's got a trash skateboard. He'll be riding around New York.
Is fucking gone.
Obi is gone.
He's gone.
He got fired.
OP is gone.
OP is fucking fired.
OP is fired.
Louis J. Gomez.
I'm not co-signing that. I love the song.
Louis, hey, it's a sing-alongable song. Louis J. Gomez going for his villain. I think you're going
I don't fucking know the guy. He never had me on his show. Fuck him. What do you want him to say? If you don't do anything for me, fuck you. If you're a comedy club that doesn't book me currently, I hope your club burns down.
Dude, I love his Tupac energy.
It's true.
That's a weird...
He comes in here with a fucking tank top.
Because the West Side is the best side.
And he goes, also, fuck them as a crew and as a staff.
Louis, can you penny board down the hall out of here?
Nice. Please do.
That's why I fucked your bitch.
That way. You can't penny board on rocks.
Yeah.
You can't trash skateboard on... Everyone knows the floor's lava.
You can't trash board on this thing.
You can't skateboard on lava.
So, this is a word TJ Moe does not want, says Liz Sets Fire.
Oh, yeah.
Who I love. I tell you what, you know what it reminded me of last night? Because they said he's been saying it on a whole bunch of shit.
I mean, I think it's funny.
I said, do you remember... first of all, I love TJ.
Yeah.
And it's obviously facetious, but like... What I thought was funny was, do you ever see the movie Beef about all the rap beefs?
Yeah, I remember that.
And he said 50 Cent tells a story when he came out with How to Rob.
Yeah.
About robbing all the rappers. And he said...
Jay-Z responded.
Jay-Z responded. He's the only one to respond, but he had the song. He goes, I'm about a dollar, what the fuck is 50 Cent? He's like, I sold a million albums off that, like, off that thing. He goes, I just sent him a bottle of champagne for that.
I know exactly what you're talking about.
Anyone like that.
Do you acknowledge it?
Although that's it. Liz Sets Fire was... Particularly when I saw her in Florida one time, was very bought into the idea that, and maybe she's right, that it was a work when Fez left radio, like furious at me, said he hated me.
You thought it was a work the whole time?
I didn't. No, I still don't. I haven't talked to Fez since. He was like...
And I was there when you asked Ronnie B off air. And he was like, well, you know, he did a very Ronnie B thing.
Yeah.
Where I was, I don't know, maybe he did. Maybe. Like, that's why Ron's the master, because he's like kind of
Over.
Like,
I don't know.
I don't know.
But Liz was like, dude, he goes, but they're saying your name like every day on the air, like a whole bunch.
Goes, yeah.
They're trying to put you over. They're trying to like, you know, doing that.
I mean,
like,
it's wrestling.
They're making this. Yeah, that's why I said, maybe it was.
I love
what's great about Ronnie B is, you're right, to this day, I don't really know.
Yeah, something to wrestle with Bruce Pritchard is my podcast I tell you about. It's so awesome. Him and Conrad Thompson. And, they're doing a live show here before SummerSlam, and he's like doing he's starting to get the fucking kayfabe thing going. He's like, I can do a way better Macho Man than Dan Soder.
Oh, really?
Yeah. And it's like, no. Yeah. Brother of love. Yeah. Everything ends. Yeah. Sundown coming for you. Yeah, it's going to be awesome.
You see this, we have somebody on the phone here. Today's going to be a bit of a caller show. We got some fun stuff coming up with callers, but,
He wants, can I do the whistling macho man? The chuckers. That's tough.
Yeah.
Everyone knows. Macho man. Gonna do the whistle. Whistle way to work. Yeah, everyone knows.
It's hard.
That's fucking hard. You gotta bend your mouth a weird way.
Steven in Virginia, you're on with the bonfire, buddy.
I tried. I'm sorry I failed you.
Steven?
Steven!
Steven!
Steven! Steven!
Steven?
Nah, we didn't find him.
We never got a hold
of him. God damn it, I want to talk about what we were talking about downstairs real quick.
Had his thoughts on Opie. Well, we got to take our first break.
We got to take our first break, but before our first break, later in the show, we want to talk about guilty pleasure of music.
Oh, yeah.
Just that sentence, because it keeps rambling around in my head to the point that it's upsetting. But if you know the song One Week by Bare Naked Ladies, you can start it by anyone's head by just going, it's been. That's all you have to do.
It's been.
Do you remember Jared Logan's joke about that?
No.
So Jared Logan, a comic in New York, he had a joke where he would just go, it's been, it's been. And it was based on Brian Baldinger, who's my old roommate, was in a commercial for Mitsubishi where they were singing that song in the car.
Oh.
I gotta pull up that commercial.
Please find that commercial.
It's been
1 week since you looked at me. Okay, I'm done. That's where I lose it. I got it. It's been, and then it's
if it says it's been 1 week, then if it just went immediately chickadee China.
It's like holding water. You open your fingers, it just goes everywhere. Is this it? Brian! Brian!
Back it up.
Whoa! Brian! That's crazy. I remember fucking smoking resin to this commercial. This is like 02.
02, exactly 02.
Is it weird? Because this is crazy. I remember sitting in my fucking bedroom in my apartment in Tucson, and I was scraping resin into a bowl, and I was smoking it, and this came on, and I kept going, it's been 1 week.
It's been.
And I was like, and I had Kazaa at the time, and I went and downloaded.
This one, too. I love the Days Go By Lancer or the Clips
this
commercial.
This one makes me uncomfortable.
Oh, I love it.
Well, Chappelle did
an Asian girl
I think
dancing
I like
in
techno.
Bar.
Yeah, Chappelle did this on Chappelle Show.
Yeah.
Episode 1 of Chappelle Show. All that shitty dancing make my dick soft. I think it was pretty sick.
Who does this song?
Dirty Vegas. I'll tell you this. I don't... Yeah, Christine's getting into it. He's fucking former druggie.
Christine's fucking... She's trying to make glow bracelets right now.
Yeah,
she's
I want a ring pop.
She goes, anybody want to do snort a line of Molly?
There's an imaginary ball in my hands.
Their music video for that song is pretty awesome because it's all breakdancing. That's the reason I know that song.
All right.
All right. And I'll fucking...
You love Dirty Vegas?
Yes, like,
yes, man. Right. Brian Ballinger now is the, he's one of the executive producers and coordinators of Ari's show.
This
is not happening. And he did a Tells.
Hey, Hugo.
He did a Tells Comedy Underground.
Brian on the production side of things has been like, he was so good to me from such an early age. Like, he put me on my first PA gig and really just like, he got me my job at Comics the first time I got a job in comedy in New York. Like, he helped me every step of the way. I love him.
Yeah, Brian's a good dude.
I love Christine, and I bake.
We're going to take a break. We'll be right back. It's the Bonfire.
And now, back to the Bonfire with Big J. Oakerson and Dan Soder.
It's been 1 week.
It's the Bonfire on Comedy Central Radio, Sirius XM 95. I'm Dan Soder. That's Big J. Oakerson. Yeah, we're not going to let you get to the lyrics. We don't even know them.
We'll just talk over them until it gets to the chickadee China, the Chinese chicken.
And then everyone can join in like we're supposed to.
I think you know every line of that.
I don't. I don't.
Sure?
I know what I know, and I don't know this.
I bet I could nail it with lyrics.
No, you can't look at lyrics.
No, now it looks like lyrics.
Yeah. You gotta go off the top.
I can't even nail it with the lyrics, though.
Me neither.
When he gets to that,
I'm so good at Shakespeare.
So dope at it.
What if we did nail it and an aggressive Jacob didn't like it?
I'm the only guy who could fuck this girl. Everyone's a fucking faggot.
It's so bad.
I'll tell you what. Can I tell you the context of that really quick?
Sure.
I was like, Jacob, I go, what do you think about that chick over there?
Yeah.
And that's what he said.
Yeah, and I go, Jacob, what do you think of, like, your superiors at Sirius?
Too many fucking faggots in this city.
Oh, Jesus. Wow. Wow.
Oh, what if he gets canned along with Opie? They just put the file in it? Like, you know when they pass a bill and they put another one under it? They're like, how's this fire Jacob too?
Might as well get him out of there.
I'd be bummed.
Ooh.
Fucking pussy.
All right, Jacob.
Jesus, Jacob.
Jesus.
Is this a part?
No.
I feel like it is.
Chicken,
it is.
Have a drumstick
and your brain starts kicking. Watching X-Files with the lights on.
Ah, you're out!
I'm getting frantic. I sing a tantric. This nigga's there, he's satisfied.
See, I don't make films, but if I did, they have a samurai.
This isn't Double Dutch. Kids jump in when you feel like it.
I love Christine.
Alright, time to go.
You love Christine, but what, Jacob? Is there a butt there?
I love Christine, and I bake.
Would you be embarrassed to share with us if you actually did know the words?
No.
You just nail it.
Dude, on Skanks the other week, I sang in its entirety the song Hanging Tough.
Whoa,
and I kind of knew the dances they did.
Hanging Tough.
Yeah.
But what's...
I know the lyrics.
What's like a real... Guilty pleasures, I think that term's overused.
Yeah, I'm not that guilty about it, but it is like the ones that you're like...
Is there anything you're embarrassed by?
I wouldn't blast this song if I was like in any kind of like traffic with a window down.
Oh, perfect way to say it.
But I want to blast it when I hear it.
What song?
It's a great song to like mean mug while I'm wearing headphones listening to it. Mine is Everywhere by Michelle Branch.
What? And what do you mean you can mean mug? Like you make an angry face while you listen to it?
Yes, because I can't let him know what I'm feeling inside. I want to be singing into a hairbrush and panties.
Yeah. When you hear this. What year is this song?
I want to play guitar and sway. What year is this?
Yeah.
I don't know. 1990 awesome. What?
And you know all the lyrics.
This is like a 10-year-old song.
Ah, she's so hot.
Yeah, she was so hot.
I think she's...
But it wasn't about that for me.
Is she dating... Patrick Kearney from the Black Keys?
She's getting married to him.
She's getting married to him?
Yeah.
Good for Patrick from the Black Keys.
Well, this is from like, this is many years ago.
Yeah, but you know all the lyrics? Oh, look, she's watching people, Jay, just like you.
Oh, we can look at windows together.
That's what the video's about. You guys could...
Yeah. Crank it. Are we watching the video and hearing it, or are you playing it?
No, I tried to sing it.
Cause you're everywhere to me.
Okay.
And when I close my eyes, it's you. I'm looking right you in the eye.
I'm looking at this. If the guy in the video is Tom Brady.
That makes me believe.
At the Bonfire SXM I'm to see the video.
Whoa, whoa. Not alone. Rocks a little though.
Do you know every lyric like by heart? Like every up and down.
Make me shake. Yeah.
Come on, let's see it.
Might not be real.
Okay.
No.
Okay. Because there's some songs that you don't really realize you know every word to. If you do Alanis Morissette's...
Away from here. Oh, air drums.
That was a good fill. That was a good fill.
For the only one, I just want to hold a big guitar and sing like sway.
So this brings joy to you.
So much. Like, I'm smiling right now. Yeah.
I'll tell you what.
The times this song is played in our house, like unironically, is ridiculous.
Unironically. On my biggest
speaker.
Oh,
the guy's at the party. He's at the party she's playing at.
Oh, dude.
He's hearing the song. I mean, you want to know what really brings me joy when it comes on random on the iPhone?
And wait. Just take the end of this in. It's almost over.
Also, I want to see where the video's going.
I want to hold your hand for this part. Crank it, Lou.
She's going downstairs to get him.
Yeah, you know they felt something.
Yeah.
And also the last chorus, the best chorus.
Good for Patrick Carney, man.
Which one's he?
He's the drummer.
Glasses. Oh, really? That doof?
Hey.
Oh, good for him.
But yeah, he's a doof.
And when I close my eyes, this doesn't make you just happy?
It does. It, I love it.
Lou.
I feel very good right now. Lou, does your Grinch heart moving at all?
Yeah, this is okay.
All right.
Like crank it. Here's my part.
Ah, get it, Jay.
Cause you're to me, and when I catch my breath, it's you I breathe.
Oh, look, now they're all partying together.
That makes me believe. Yeah, it's a good one. But it does the job. Lou, you do have a Krampus heart, and I really...
I do, I don't know.
I feel like that makes you... You don't like the hug or anything.
Does that make you feel anything?
It doesn't make me feel like I want to be hugged.
Okay. Well, but what I was saying
but
is...
did it make you happy?
Yeah. Oh, Christine.
Oh, Christine hugged
get
him.
In there. I
love Christine, and right. I bake.
Alanis Morissette's Head Over Feet is like
that's
a song.
One of yours?
It's tattooed.
And I want people to start calling in and start telling us your, like, real embarrassing one that you love.
Oh, this is.
You stayed in your case and again.
Do you know all the words?
I'll catch in. Oh, yeah.
Oh, hey, Fonz.
I'm a princess.
At least my song's unisex.
I'm angry at a man now. You've already won me over.
You don't know this? Off the classic Jagged Little
Pill? I love
Pill.
Running my fingers through your chest hair.
That's Jay's age gap. I think this was...
I love being
plowed by your big hog. I want to kiss it. It chokes me out. Your hands are strong. You treat me like a lady and help me out of the car. You hold the doors for me.
I can't carry groceries
because I'm too frail. You always pay when we dance. I sit down when I pee. I have a pussy. I love the smell of your dress shirts and all of your suits. I get afraid by violence. And you kill my bugs.
I love this song.
Can you help me put it?
She's so hot. I love Alanis Morissette.
You help me.
I was in love with her, and I'll fight you, Christine.
You help me open all of my jars. You reach all the things on the top shelf. I will take your last name. You are my king and I your queen. Head over feet.
That's fucking great.
You always,
my song is a girl, but it was definitely unisex.
You walk me home. I'm always afraid. I like when I'm chilly and you put your sweater around my arms. I love to be the little spoon. I cheer at your ball games and wear your dress shirts. I have your giant ring hanging on a thin necklace around my neck. I lay on your chest and look up at you.
Alright, yeah, well.
You put out... me on your insurance, and for that I thank you.
Oh, fuck. Yeah, that's one of those guilty pleasures where you're like, I don't really realize how much it made me sound like a lady.
That one gets you.
I love it. It makes me happy.
Yeah.
I hear that song, and it just makes me happy.
I got a bunch of them.
You know? There's a couple.
Look, I said Toto Africa.
Yeah, but
that's not embarrassing at all. I'm just saying, but it's a song that always makes me happy.
844-COMEDY-9, if you have a song that you are embarrassed by. Wait, mouth by...
Wait, is this Lou's?
No, this is mine.
What is this?
What?
Oh, wait.
This is a guilty pleasure?
Did this just come out in Sweden? I've never heard this song.
It's very interracial. This is your guilty pleasure? Why is it a guilty pleasure?
No one knows this.
It sounds like music you would listen to.
I feel like it's such a dumb song, and the amount of affection I have for it is ridiculous.
Let me tell you this. All shitty music.
Let me tell you this right now. The music video looks like a mouthwash commercial.
I've lived with Jay for 3 years. I just got comfortable playing my music in the house, like, this month.
And I still complain. It is nonsense. You know that fucking beach garbage rock when I'm taking a shower and everybody hears that boop
I'm like, Christine, can you please give me a fucking towel?
Jack Johnson.
And the waves are crashing and my lady's fine and I love everybody.
This Christine isn't guilty pleasure.
I've never heard of Meryl Banded Bridge. What's her
You've
name?
Heard this song
it was
before.
The Better Roses soundtrack, I think.
I do.
The fuck bought the soundtrack for Better Roses?
Christine did several times. When her CD booklet got taken, she immediately went to the store and bought another copy.
After I pawned them all.
Yeah.
She went to the tower. That's the only thing she went back to the pawn shop to get back.
She goes, do you guys have it? They go, sorry, miss, sold as soon as you gave it to her. Everyone loves Mouth by Meryl Blackridge. By Meryl Banded Bridge.
This is, come on now.
I can't be bad at Big Jokerson for Michelle Branch. I myself listen to Norah Jones with the car windows up.
Omi!
At Bronx Omi.
He's the fucking... so not Hispanic.
No, he is, but I think everyone has that. Patrice used to have that bit about the Beatles, about how he loves listening to the Beatles, but he couldn't do it with the windows down.
Yeah, but he was lying. like a Beatle.
This isn't a guilty pleasure because I don't know it, I guess.
I do know it. It's not a guilty pleasure because it sounds like... But like then everything you listen to is your guilty pleasure.
I don't. Well, what I feel like all my music is a guilty pleasure when it comes to you. But like, what would be a guilty pleasure for a chick?
Like if you like really like listen unironically to like Skeelo's, you know, I Wish I Was a Baller.
I mean, I love that song.
Yeah, who doesn't
love that song?
That's a great song. That's a bad example.
Too.
You hate that song?
I wish I had a girl who looked good, I would call her.
What do you... Well, Lou, do you have any guilty pleasures? A man like you has to be sitting on some secrets.
Sure. Mine's kind of old-fashioned, like 70s.
Okay. That's
like what? Oh, yeah. I mean, I would say that the Method Man Mary J. Blige one is
which I like too, but without the rapping.
This is a guilty pleasure, for sure, because I would have never...
Sarah McPants says, I'd only been listening to the show to finally hear Dan sing I'm a Princess, so I can tap out now. That's been real good.
And then she just flies away.
Yeah, I love it. Sarah McPants is the best. Yeah. This is great. This is...
Marvin Gaye, Tammy Terrell.
Yeah, I just know the Method Man and Mary J. Blige.
The only problem is the fact it's Marvin Gaye. It's
makes
cool.
It cool. Makes it cool. Is it cool? I'll tell you this. I like this is gayer than saying I'm a princess. Donna Summer's Last Dance. I remember being like 13 and be like, the song's kind of cool.
Yeah, that's a guilty pleasure. That's a good example. Yeah. How about this one? You got Blue by Eiffel 55?
Fuck that shit, dude. I went to spring break in Cancun the year that came out, and I wanted to fist fight.
Of course you did.
Yeah, dude, I was 16. It was fucking awesome. It was, by the way, bad parenting move by Trish. Great move for 16-year-old Dan. I mean, now that's cartel territory.
Do you want to pick one that's less cool?
16 years old?
For you, yeah. Did you hear mine, though, that I told you to bring up?
No, which one?
Fuck, I'm so watching so many different songs. What I just said.
Oh, I said,
Blue by Eiffel 55.
But Len, Steal My Sunshine.
Because he plays a cool song.
Is it?
Yes.
We
if you say.
That the other day.
What's that?
Last time we were in LA, we drove down La Cienega listening to Steal My Sunshine.
Steal My Sunshine. Oh, thanks. And everything.
I'm walking on the park. And see it.
Oh, God, that guy, you could tell that guy stinks by the way he sings.
Oh, yeah.
He goes, hey, do you want a skateboard I found in the trash? I go, you should hang out with Louis J. Gomez.
Here we go now.
This song.
Now, I know, crank it, Lou. You have to feel this one in your soul.
I hate this song.
You know where it goes?
Yes.
Well, that's why my point is it's a guilty pleasure. Because it's ridiculous.
Like Blue. Hold on, pause it real quick. I didn't realize how crusty of a European accent he has, where he goes, I'm the house, and it's blue. And you are there, and it's also blue. This is dance music, America. Go back. It sounds like a fucking...
Oh, I listen to the lyrics.
Borat character.
And a blue house
with
everything is blue for him and himself and everybody around.
And he got nobody to listen to. Dance.
It sounds like the first ringtone. I hate it.
Did anybody you knew ever say, if I were green, I would die? I'm blue, if I were green, I would die. Was that just like
No, you're making that up.
Yeah, you're making that up.
For Justin Silver, we made it, I'm blue, I wear blue so I can meet all the guys.
You know what else?
Actually, Justin Silver, I'm wrong. I'm remembering history wrong there. Actually, Justin Silver, maybe telling about him, said he thought the lyrics were, I wear blue so I can meet all the guys. I like to meet lots of guys. I like to. Now, do that in a Justin voice.
super fun. I wear blue so I can meet all the guys. I like to meet all the guys. I like to meet lots of guys.
This music video is god awful. You know what other song came out?
Really? Damn, you make a better video with fucking animation.
I would love to.
Stop motion.
I'd love
fucking
to.
Film.
You know
yeah,
what?
Yeah, no, you're great.
I'll get people together and
you're
we'll
great.
Fucking
Eiffel
do a new
Eiffel 65 sucks dick in the year. Yeah. Possible making
I'll
a video.
Fight all of Eiffel 65.
I forgot you went to IT Tech for fucking.
Well, this looks like a commercial for that.
It does look like a commercial for IT Tech.
Make cool videos.
Make your own video game.
Make your own music video.
If you really like this and don't, I'm not joking around, then this is a guilty pleasure. I hate it.
Can I tell you this? It was on FIFA and I liked it. I used to listen to it on FIFA.
You get excited when it would come on. You'd be like, oh,
it reminded me of playing the main screen on FIFA. You know what? Oh, fuck. I just had... You know what other song came out that's kind of a guilty pleasure at the same time as Blue? Cisco's Thong Song.
That's...
The music video...
Here's why it's not guilty.
The music video sold it for
sure.
me.
Sure. Here's why that's not guilty pleasure. If it's on, I'm not furious that it's on, but I've never saw that. And if it came across something I was listening to and I could change it, I would. So it makes sense. I don't hate that song, but so to call it guilty pleasure. To me, guilty pleasure means when it comes on, you're like, nice.
Oh, no. This isn't a guilty pleasure.
I'll tell you another one of mine, you can do. Scatman.
Oh, well, who doesn't love that? I mean, I've told that story several times in college when my buddy Kyle was on my roommate's computer just giggling, and the Scatman was playing, and he was watching a scat porn compilation to that song.
Oh, yeah.
And it's forever changed.
I mean, I think
Oh, look at that. I love that the phone lines are all lit up. Okay, Brett in Boston. I want to talk to Brett in Boston on line three. Brett, I just love it. What's your guilty pleasure?
There's a couple of them. Two Kelly Clarkson songs.
I mean, can you just say Kelly Clarkson again one more time for me?
I knew you were going to say that.
Yeah.
Kelly Clarkson.
Yeah, that's what it is. He goes, fucking nothing gets
Kelly
me.
Kelly fucking Clarkson,
right? It's the perfect fucking soundtrack for this robot call.
I don't think you understand. Fucking Brett in Boston, my friend told me he loves Kelly Clarkson. Hey, Kelly Clarkson, your songs make me super emotional. And also, you know what makes me emotional? These robots.
Hey, Brett, you want me to play that fucking song again?
So you have what Kelly Clarkson song, Brett?
Since You've Been Gone and Stronger.
I don't know Stronger, but since you've been gone,
yes,
I think I do
I'm
like
on board
it.
With it. I'm
I think
on
I
board.
Like it.
Because you know what happened is I got excited to sing the chorus when he said it, where she really just gets into it. Do you roll your windows up and just let it go?
I roll my windows down. And
yeah.
Let it go.
Oh, well, you're in Boston, so you guys are seeking for
you know
fun.
What? It's silly enough. It's also silly enough. That like you can have your windows down on people will all you can trust other people will like it enough
yeah
and, but also look over they're kind of like ah it's hilarious bro right
it's a dude listening hey fuck you that's funny I fucking like Kelly Clarkson too hey yeah you fucking softy
yeah cough.
That's a fucking great one God bless yeah Brett in Boston thank you for calling in that's a fucking great one and with that Boston
thanks,
accent
guys.
Makes it perfect Adam
are you
in
playing
Philly-
why are you playing it Lou
oh okay.
We gotta feel all
this. I mean, you're the perfect.
I'm alright.
That's right in the Lou Witzke wheelhouse.
I said you're gonna be DJing today. I just wanna be with you. The fuck? Guess you never felt that way. Gotta get to a chorus.
I hear. Everyone
oh my god, I wanna have wet, long hair and just take it off.
I wanna be wearing socks in a living room. Just
I don't
screaming.
Even care.
I hate you, Dad!
I'm wearing like kind of see-through panties where you can see like I have an odd dark line that goes down my stairs.
I have a flesh-colored bra on under my boyfriend's dress shirt.
I don't care.
Oh, yeah, I'm hormonal because it's almost my period. But I don't give a shit.
That's a good one.
Oh, man, go to line five, please. I think it's from Philadelphia. Is this Alex? Adam. Adam from Philly.
Yeah.
Hey, what's up, dude? Turn your radio down.
Hey, sorry about that.
Oh, it's all right. Dude, what's your guilty pleasure?
Oh, you guys are killing me with this conversation. That's great. What? This is a totally stupid-ass song. That Kiss from a Rose by...
Kiss from a Rose? I just love that all the accents are playing right into the fucking song.
Kiss from a Rose by Seal?
I don't know. Yeah. I like to go home and listen to Kiss from a Rose.
Batman movie. It was.
Oh, dude, yeah, that's where I bought the soundtrack because of that song.
He was in fucking Batman.
Yeah. Yeah, I guess Robin was there over at the Bruce Wayne Robin, Manor.
They were in the cave.
Oh, they were in the cave. They were in the cave. With the bats. And
there's a bunch of bats in the cave.
Yeah, there it is.
And Alfred came up. He's their butler.
And he brings them hoagies whenever they want.
I wish I had an Alfred to give me a hoagie whenever I want.
Adam, thanks for calling in. I mean, this song
is... Yeah, thanks. Thanks for taking the call, guys.
Oh, of course, man. Brother. This is easily one of the greatest... This came on in my rental car in Denver, and I left it. I let it go. Hannah was talking, and I was like, "Hey, shh, shh,
my eyes become alive." And
you know this about cocaine? It kind of kills it.
Baby, yeah, I want to hate it more than I ever do, but it's not a guilty pleasure for me. We have Melissa in Philly.
Another Philly.
Line 3. Melissa.
Sir.
Hello. Oh,
are you calling from a stairwell?
Are you calling from a speakerphone in the tub?
I'm smoking pot in my living room.
Yeah.
Sick. That's what I picture all of our fans are doing right now. And what's your guilty pleasure song?
Believe by Cher.
Now, can I ask how old you are before I call this a guilty pleasure?
I'm 25.
Oh. So this is kind of like you were young. You were young when this came out.
Definitely.
But it just means something to you. Does it hold some sort of attachment to you, or just makes you happy?
I don't know. I get real excited and dance around like an asshole.
Yeah.
Oh my God. Are you dance? If you do dance like an asshole right now, because we're playing it for you, could you send a video of you being on our Twitter?
Maybe.
What year did she come out?
Is it that embarrassing? You're dancing.
No, I don't look good right now.
Okay. Well, this is a good, this is the first auto-tune.
Yeah, this came out in like 1999 because I'm obsessed with Cher and I went to this tour and it was supposed to be her farewell tour and she's done like 10 since.
Yep.
But yeah, this isn't even guilty for me. I just think it's a great album.
Well, you're a little older than her, Christine, a little bit.
A little bit.
Lou, how's this one make you feel?
Do you believe?
Fierce.
Yes, get it, Lou. Yes, Mr. Thing.
Dance, bitch. Ageless, timeless. Like,
do you believe in life after your ex-husband goes into a tree? After you leave? Cause sometimes your exes kill themselves while they're doing extreme sports. You go, this is dark.
Now my daughter is a boy.
Life has gone to hell and back.
Performance.
Hell back. Skiing killed her dad. She cut off her penis.
Oh, shit.
Yeah, guilty pleasure.
No, she had dick put on.
Oh, that's what it is. Elbow skin, bro. Elbow
skin. Whatever they use.
Usually use like thigh meat or elbow skin.
I think thigh meat for the shaft, elbow skin for the peckerhead.
Totally. You got to get that helmet. Fucking, that funny bone sensitivity.
Wow. I look a lot like Chaz Bono. It looks like if me and Haley Joel Osment had a kid.
Also, I'm very jealous of the beard that he can grow. I can't get that.
She has a way better beard than me.
But is it weird that it also...
Hey, ladies.
It also looks like poodle belly.
Oh, man. She was a hot chick, too.
Wow. Well, now he's got a good beard.
Yeah, it all started going south. Yeah, you know what? She got to a point where it really was she'd be a hotter dude.
What a way to jump ship.
Yeah. Don't try to get back to be a hot chick again.
I feel like time is running out. Let me go. Should we take our next break and come back more with more guilty pleasures?
Oh, yeah. People keep calling in. You know the number, 844-COMEDY-9. We'll be right back. We got to hear. I know Lou's got to have one. We got a lot of people in this room and a lot of people calling in. It's the Bonfire.
Too many fucking faggots in this city.
And now, back to the Bonfire with Big J. Oakerson and Dan Soder.
It's been 1 week since you looked.
Hey, everybody, we're back to the Bonfire. It's
Comedy Central Radio, Sirius XM 95. I'm Dan Soder. That's Big J. Oakerson.
Hey-o.
Big J. Oakerson is going to be at the Dead Crow Comedy Club, Wilmington, North Carolina, this Friday and Saturday. Go get tickets at BigJComedy.com. And then also Monday, July 17th is the 3-year anniversary of the SDR show. It's going to be an Exile Bar above 2A in New York City. It'll be Team Big J versus Team Ralph Sutton for Family Feud with Consequences. So come hang out and celebrate with the SDR show. Show starts at 10 p.m. Again, that's July 17th, the 3-year anniversary. of the SDR shit.
It's always a filthy fun time when Ralph puts on an event with me. So he really buys into the filth, and I appreciate that about him. Make sure you guys come out, though. Let's try to fill that thing up. It's going to be a lot of fun. And Dan, of course, we all know, is half-hour special. As part of the stand-up series, is available right now on Netflix. Go watch it. It's absolutely hilarious. Everyone does great on it. And Nate, though, you guys are my buddies.
Yeah, they bookended.
So maybe I'm biased, but goddamn.
A lot of great comics on there, but it's fun to be.
You guys are so great. Both of you are fantastic. Both fantastic.
The opening shot is us doing an awkward handshake, so it's pretty great.
And also, campers out in Minneapolis, you can catch Dan Soder at Acme Comedy Club Thursday, July 13th through Saturday, July 15th. Get all the tickets for any of Dan's shows, those and more at dansoder.com. And also, follow us at The Bonfire SXM on Twitter, Instagram, and Facebook.
Yeah. Oh, and that's where it is. That's where we know the song. We're doing Guilty Pleasures songs that you don't want, but it's like more than Guilty Pleasures because I feel like Guilty Pleasures have been covered a lot, but these are songs that you're embarrassed.
These songs are just kind of like that when you put it on, you're not, you hope no one's around and you can blast it because.
So that is a Guilty Pleasure.
Yeah.
But this song I have totally fucking forgot about, and then Gymnastics on Twitter, he's at the Ryan Jacobs, so I don't know. He picks two different.
Did
names.
We ever find Scatman?
But this song.
Play this one first.
Cause. I got so excited. Weedus's Teenage Dirtbag. Weedus! I fucking loved this song. And I forgot
where's this from?
The late 90s?
Oh, it was the Jason. Yeah. It was
Jason
from
Biggs
some.
Film?
A Jason Biggs movie. Yeah. A Jason Biggs joint. But I fucking had this on a mix CD. Or maybe he's just in the video.
Well, I have a dream about her. She rings my bell.
Well, something with him and Mina Suvari.
He has the opposite voice of me.
She rocks and kids and tube socks.
It's Jacob voice.
Damn, you know it.
This is a guilty pleasure.
And she doesn't know who's damn about me. Because I'm just a teenage stupid.
Is that guy wearing a W Train shirt?
It's an American Pie.
That's what it is.
Iron Maiden, baby.
Oh, I'll tell you, can I tell you what?
Loser.
Yeah, that's what it is.
Yeah.
I was going to say Pecker, but it's Loser. Pecker, I believe, is Eddie Furlong. I used to really like, actually, I shouldn't say used to. I'll take a good guilty pleasure one for me.
Yeah.
Tonic, If You Could Only See the Way.
Oh, yeah. I know exactly what you're talking about. That, now you're starting to get into dangerous territory because I had a,
you look like a jerk off cranking that somewhere.
Oh, if you come back and you go, hey, I had a good time. You put this on and turn around with two glasses of red wine. You go, you know, I had a really good time meeting you at that Applebee's tonight.
You know what's tough about it is that if you look at the video, if you look at Tonic,
yeah,
it's another dad. It's a dad band.
Oh, this is total dad rock.
No, I'm saying, but the guys look like they're dead. So,
but even now,
you want a picture like a young,
yeah,
fucking intense, like lustful romance thing, and it's just
hair.
Like it looks like Paul Giamatti.
Does it?
Oh yeah,
man.
Tonic never looks cool.
I should pitch them him. Oh, there it is. They really do look like dads.
Well, you gotta get to the.
Oh!
When you got your reason. Yeah,
like,
man.
Oh. They all look like they work at an insurance company. Where they're like, that's Tim. He handles claims.
He deals with all of our libel.
Yeah, he's pretty good.
This is back then. Now what must they look like?
I would love to see Tonic now.
Can you put up a video of Tonic doing this song recently? I know they've done it. There's got to be a Six Flags Over somewhere.
Or
this.
Yeah, or a wedding anniversary that they played.
Barb, Thomas.
I just want to say you're doing a lot of great things in Silicon Valley. So we're just happy we had out here tonight in Palo Alto. It's a beautiful backyard. This one goes right now to Ryan and Becky. Celebrating their... Yes, there they are!
2015?
And they all look like Jim Florentine.
I want to see him. By the way, he must have started propitiating right there because his hair was bad, but it stayed right there.
Do you think he got the LeBron James surgery?
Oh, they took his ass muff?
I don't know.
Is that what they do?
Yeah, LeBron James? I don't know if Dayrock can afford that, though. Because he's playing. They're playing during the day.
They are playing during the day. This is too far away. I need a close up of them playing this recently.
This, I mean that's, well, no, Conan O'Brien when he's 19 years old. So there's no way.
This one. I like this one. There's people walking by them.
Yeah, they're like, is that Tom?
Oh, no, that's not allowed. That's the video. I'm an idiot.
If you could only see. I mean, now we're getting into Rob Thomas territory.
Yeah, well, I'm telling you, listen.
If
you,
look at this. You go, hey, pause it. You go, Mr. Markinson, is Ashley home? And he's like, sorry, me and my buddies are just playing. This looks like that Viagra commercial.
You want to chill in the garage?
Yeah.
Hang out? Me and my Cialis bros, knock on some wood?
Yeah. If your mom was here, she'd be squirting if she heard this song. Hit it, guys. One, two, three.
Play it. If I'll be honest with you, though, dude, yeah, how much more pussy my life would have got if I could just do this song?
Right now, guitar. Watching him play acoustic?
If you told me I couldn't learn one other song on guitar, if I could not look and sing and play this, there's a piano song like that in the world,
that's,
too.
Yeah.
I don't know what
piano
it is.
Piano Man.
Piano Man might be the one. There's got to be
dude,
some song.
You knock
song
that out on a
we
fucking...
like, I just need to learn one song on each instrument.
Sarah McPants said, I worked at a Sam Goody store in 2001, and this show is like all the songs people would come in and ask about buying.
Oh, yeah. Cracker Low.
Oh, man. Yeah, this was the final throes of the record store.
Now, yeah, this is...
Oh, good. Look at it. If you were nailing that. If you were just...
I gotta do that fucking that mall singer voice.
It's down to size.
Down to size.
I still put product in my hair.
Don't shake it down when you do. Shake it down, get down, get down, no. Shake it down now.
Ah. Well, the one guilty pleasure I have is that song by 3 Days Grace, since I want to fist fight them.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, I mean, whose is this guilty pleasure? This isn't a
all
guilty pleasure.
All of ours.
This is
we
just
sang
a hit. This is something that just gets me going. You want to say Santana's Smooth is a guilty
give
pleasure?
Give me a holla, make it real. Holla, forget about.
Everyone's singing that song now.
Yeah, no one doesn't not
get
sing
Santana
Smooth.
Get Santana out of here.
No, get Santana in here. Look at that girl in that music video. Smooth? Rob Thomas is fucking catcalling. I totally forgot how hot the girl in the video was.
Is that his wife?
No.
I think it's his wife. I'm pretty sure it's his wife.
Oh, Santana. Looking like he's at an OTB all the time. Rob Thomas looks like a drunk frat boy in that cowboy hat.
Where's the call screen? Let's get the call screen up. Also, we have two guests in the audience that say we're missing some.
Oh, yeah.
Guilty pleasures.
From the Legion of Skanks, Intern Olympics.
It's Mike and Alex. Alex, you say we're missing one. What is the one we're missing?
You guys are missing Girl on TV by LFO.
I don't know if I know that one.
I don't know if any...
It had Jennifer Love Hewitt in the music video, so I think Dan will remember it.
I do. I was a big Jennifer Love
I don't know
Hewitt.
Why you threw it all to him. That was my... Dude... I used to
who jerked off more to Jennifer Love Hewitt?
Me
or you?
I used to be on my knees in front of the TV when Ethan Embry was proposing his love to her and Can't Hardly Wait. I was like,
I remember Party of Five, bro. I had her scouted back then with a clipboard.
But you're a pedophile.
Okay, dude. I was 11.
I liked her as an adult.
I was younger.
Yeah, sure. Whatever you want to tell yourself, make yourself feel.
Where could you bring up that girl on TV, LFO? Because that's it.
This is the song.
That's not a guilty pleasure.
No,
at all.
The song you're listening to is Girl on TV. I don't know. Yeah, Mike, you agree. Wait, how old are you, Mike?
29.
And you're on board with this.
And Alex is 24. I've never heard this song before.
No,
Well, Girls for the Summer was like a big single back in the day.
I remember Girls for the Summer, and it fucking made me furious. Chinese food makes me sick.
Chinese
I like
food.
Girls wear Abercrombie and Fitch. You like that? So that's a guilty
There's
pleasure.
There's a guilty pleasure. Because that's a jack
here's the
song.
Here's the real definition. If it can make someone else violently angry, the way that that song makes me feel.
This is, I pulled this up because...
Dance with Barbie?
It's Dance Workout with Barbie, and it's
she went by Love Hewitt at the time, but Love Hewitt is right there. And this was my favorite dance workout video as a kid. I used to watch it obsessively, and she's in it.
I'll tell you what. I don't know what age she is. She's not even budding yet, because I'll tell you what. Those things grew up to be preposterous.
It's like when the marshmallow overcooks and it just comes out, you're just like, oh, whoa, 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 whoa.
Oh, yeah, she had to stop dancing. She was going to give herself black eyes.
Yeah. Bring up the, I mean, Jennifer Love Hewitt, 99 to what? Oh, I mean, even through the Ghost Whisperer.
Yeah, she's always been hot.
Japanese pop.
She was a rape victim in SVU.
Okay.
Hot enough.
Jesus.
Was that?
There you go. I mean, let me get back to this Barbie dance video, but you're gross.
All right, Christine.
Christine's
doing it. Can we get the call screen up? I want to know.
Christine's just Mike, nailing it.
Mike, you said you got one.
Yeah, no, I hated this song until I heard it at UFC 200 last year. Misha Tate came out to it. Katy Perry's Roar.
Oh, that's a guilty. Cause I'll
I will
tell
turn
you
the windows up and rock out to that.
I'll tell you this.
Hard.
That's Mike, that's a great one. Because that is one where you're like, why do I feel everything? Yeah.
Oh, I got another one.
Yeah, if it makes you feel anything. Ah, that's really making me angry that I'm...
But you would choose to leave it on? He's saying he chooses... I would never choose to leave it on. If it's on in the background.
If it's on in the background, I would... but, yeah.
That's a
guilty pleasure. That's a fucking great guilty pleasure, though.
Christine, what's the one I like? Dynamite by Something Crew or Tal Cruz or whatever? You know what I'm talking about?
No.
Cause we gonna light it up like it's dynamite. Oh, dun, dun, don't you want better? Yeah.
What is this?
This is my guilty, one of my guilty pleasures.
Ladies and gentlemen, Las Vegas welcomes...
In the air, so...
Big J. Oakerson.
Actually, wait, pause it for a second. I'll tell you what.
Sorry, guys. Show's canceled.
You want this to become even gayer?
Yeah.
Is that this song came out when me and Dave Smith were hanging out a lot. And yeah. Jokingly, we would crank this song.
On the drive.
Quote, jokingly.
Yeah.
And go, I throw my hands up in the air sometimes saying, ayo. Dave and Jay.
Oh, God. No, when you personalize it, it makes it
it's so
ten
bad.
Times worse.
Crank it up, Lou.
Fucking faggot.
Whoa, Jacob.
Wow. Fucking pussy.
Hey, there's HR here, pal.
You're a fucking faggot.
Hey, dude, watch your fucking mouth,
too
Jacob.
Many fucking faggots
dude,
in this
Jacob,
city.
It's not cool, dude. It's not cool. And I'm sure Sirius doesn't think of it. Oh. Can I tell you something?
That you like.
Oh.
That I'm always asking you about.
Oh, I'm not sure if it's what you're saying with Florence.
No, no, no,
Calvin,
no, no, no.
Put
no,
that one on.
Not
that's
Calvin.
Nothing. You played this on that show.
No, you played that. But no, the other one where it's like.
You get all gassed up.
You downloaded it when you download all those Fantagram songs too.
Guys, can we talk
it's
about.
A girl?
Can we go back to Weedus? Because that really made me feel something.
Put on Weedus.
And I totally
we
forgot.
We gotta go to the call screen though.
No, we gotta go to the call screen. Don't worry about Weedus. I was kidding. We've already played enough of it. Oh, Shane in California. You just hit one of mine, and I didn't even fucking realize it. Shane, what's up, dude?
What's up, guys?
Oh, man, what's your guilt? What's the song that you love? That oh, man, I love this song.
I love it. I'm going to slow it down for you guys. It's Tracy Chapman. I'm trying to keep in that same time frame as the Alanis Morissette and stuff. And
yeah.
Go with Fast Car.
Dude, love it. Love it. Okay, you want to know something crazy about this? Brian Koppelman, buddy of Jay and I's, creator of Billions, discovered her.
Really?
Yeah.
Really?
You know what's weird? When this song came out, I was like, I don't know why he's so sad with these songs. He's a handsome dude. And then I was like, oh, it's a very unattractive woman.
I would say this is not a guilty pleasure, and this is just a classic
song.
Yeah,
I think
song
it's a good song.
Okay. All right.
Yeah,
because I wouldn't mind if the windows were down on this.
By the way, I wouldn't even say that I love it, but then when it goes, I remember when we were driving in the house, if you do this, we're doing Luca by fucking Suzanne Vega.
But wait, hold on. I want to keep talking in Tracy Chapman voice.
I'm a little bit hungry. Gotta put some food, put it in our bellies.
I'm going through the drive-thru. I say, may I have a Big Mac and also a fish fillet?
They say, do you want a super size? I said, you know it, nigga. Put that in.
Getting real. Wait, who's Luca? Oh, Tracy Chapman with long hair. I don't know if it does it for me as much as the short.
None of it should do it for you.
The track star hair?
Tracy Chapman was not an attractive woman. But a great song. But I don't know, yeah, if it really goes in there. Where's back to the call screen?
Alex is right.
The guy from LFO died, though, which is bad news. All right.
Well, I mean, I'm not trying to feel bad about it. I just hated that song. Maybe that song killed him. Maybe Chinese food. He ate Chinese food that made him sick, and he died. Is that too mean? Is that too mean?
He goes, I actually had a pretty severe allergy.
He goes, that wasn't a joke. I tried to put it out there so all the catering knew. Chinese food makes me sick. I have Crohn's, and it can make me die.
Chinese food.
I'll shit myself to death.
Here's a guilty pleasure song if it's real. Yeah, let's do Robert in Texas.
Yeah, dude. You know what, Robert? First off, thanks for calling in. Second off, what do you look like?
I don't know, 6 foot, long hair, beard.
There we go. That's what I was exactly hoping you were going to say. A long-haired, bearded dude from Texas. And what's the song that you love?
Backstreet Boys, Backstreet Sex.
Dude? It came on at the end of the movie. What movie did it come on at the end? This is the End.
Popstar?
At the end of This is the End when they go to heaven.
This is the End, right. That's what it is.
And I loved it. And I never thought I hated the song when it came out.
It's called Everybody. That's this song, right?
Yes.
Yeah.
Oh, damn it. With my windows down.
You'll put the windows
down. Is this the one where they were in the Haunted Mansion video?
Yeah.
Well, it's the MTV VMA performance is one of the best of all time.
Oh, let's watch that.
Yeah, because they got... Yeah, this is that song.
Oh my God, we're back.
Oh my God, we're back. Oh.
I've always fancied myself the AJ of the Bonfire.
Oh, really?
Gonna bring a plan to show you how. Gotta crush you for you better answer.
Crush the VMAs.
Yeah. I feel like I want to dress like Nick Carter's dresses here, but it's way too...
I feel like young Nick Carter.
Oh, yo, it's Dan Soder, a.k.a. the young Nick Carter.
Is it sexual?
Yeah, man, what a... You know, when a boy band really does it, they nail it.
Yeah, Christine really is overly impressed with his performance, if I'm being honest.
We've watched a lot of fucking new
amazing live performances, and this is
this isn't the one I was thinking of. They have another one where they all come out in Victorian garb.
Oh, I like that you just said Victorian garb. She goes, it's classic setting.
Hey, Betsy Johnson.
Yeah, it's obviously you don't know about good live performances. Yeah, this is just
things.
Too many fucking...
All right, Jacob.
Come on.
Jacob.
Stop. Come on.
They look like they're just doing a teleconference, like a big teleconference. Christine, I hate to veto this. Besides Nick Carter's cool threads, this is a bust.
Go back to the call screen. There's another one I'd like to hear the voice attached to this request.
Yeah, that's what you always want to hear.
Brett in Wyoming.
Yes. Hi, Brett.
Hey.
Hey, Brett.
Hey, Brett.
Oh, Brett, you got to turn your radio down.
Oh, my bad. I got it over the car speaker.
Oh, no worries. Brett, what's your guilty pleasure?
Party in the USA by Miley Cyrus.
That's...
Yeah. I'll tell you who else loves this? Our good friend Nate Bargatze.
Oh, yeah. But Nate...
But this is his wheelhouse.
The shittiest music. But I get it.
Yeah.
It's a good... But again, I don't know if I always turn it up, but I'm saying 1 out of 5, I might crank it up.
Yeah. Yeah, good call, Brett. Up in Wyoming, this is a tough one to listen to. Do you listen...
I pump it up because my friend in college, he got hammered and jumped up on a table and did an Irish jig to it. And the table cracked in half and he broke his arm. So
Jesus.
Every time it comes on, I bump it.
Yeah, all right.
Oh, okay.
This one for your buddy.
This is memories.
Yeah, this is a nostalgia.
You got to tie it back to memories if it's a guilty pleasure.
Yeah, you're right. Well, that's how you stomach it. But how we stomach it, it's just a sick-ass song. Blair, Lou.
Party. I'll tell you what.
Yeah, thanks, Brett.
How about Nick in Fresno?
This is the one I want to know, because this is a true...
I'll be honest, this is one for me, too, I'll say. I think this is one for me. Nick, you there?
Nick, turn down your radio.
It's hard because everyone's enjoying the music.
Yeah, because you're doing that thing where we're tempting them with the sweet honey of
Nick,
shitty
you there,
rock.
Buddy?
Yeah, how's it going, guys?
What's going on, Nick? What's your guilty pleasure song?
It's Complicated by Avril Lavigne.
Cranked up full volume.
Oh, fuck yeah, every time. 10 out of 10 times.
You know why I hate this song? When I worked in Alaska, the only radio station they let us listen to was Top 40.
Uh-huh.
And they would play this fucking every hour on the hour.
But even now that you're stepped away from it for a few years?
Hold on, let's sink in.
You gotta get
bit.
To a chorus.
Hold on.
It's very important.
Let's see, she married the lead singer of Nickelback, so there might...
So you respect her.
Yeah.
You don't like her, but you respect her.
Goddamn right.
Turn, you gotta let us feel it, though.
I just remembered one that I rolled up my windows to crank in a rental car in Los Angeles.
What's that?
Gotta Be by Dion, by Desiree.
You gotta be. Really? Oh, dude. That's fucking hilarious.
That was my inspirational on International Women's Day. That was one of my song choices.
Oh, was it? Yeah, that was.
All I know, all I know. Love
it came on. Thing. It came on. I have just the song on my iTunes, and I was in the rental car, and I was in LA. It was when I was doing This Not Happening, and I was driving somewhere, and all my windows were down, and it came up, and I had to do the four window up on the automatics.
Oh, wow.
Because I was like,
I'm not turning this off.
I'm definitely not turning this off.
I mean, get to it.
No, we're doing a pop-up video?
What?
Oh, damn it. It's going to be all with all pop-up video noises. Desiree's dead.
She went to charge. She went to jail for international racketeering.
She never owned the rights to the song, so she never made a dime after. Sad pop-up video. Just get all the legalities into it.
Last seen running out of a methadone clinic.
Husband left her for a younger woman.
Desiree.
Up to the sky.
And you cranked it.
Fucking hey, I did.
Were you stoned a little?
Yeah, very.
Yeah. That'll make a big difference.
Oh, and the sun was setting, and I was just like, no one has to know I'm loving this song. I mean, on car stereo, when it gets going, on a good rental car stereo, we don't really care, so you can...
I'm not hating it. Yeah. Back to the call screen for a second. Some of these we don't have to take, because in the Cranberries.
Oh, Mike in Arizona
song. Brought
up the thong song. We don't have to take that one, but Mike in Arizona brought up thong song, which talked about it's one that I don't turn off, but I don't seek. Desiree is like, I think, the exact example I'm going for.
I'll tell you what, Mark in Michigan.
Nah, I can't. This is one of the ones that make me angry. I'm not on board
really?
With it.
Really? Oh, see, this is a timing thing for you then.
How? How is that a timing thing? We're both old enough.
No, but you said when you were doing something in radio, something where you had to hear Top 40 constantly.
Oh, no, that was...
It was a song that was on. It makes you angry.
Oh, but no, I just didn't like this song. In fact, it was Mick Jagger. We can take it.
Moves Like Jagger?
Yeah. What year was that? Was that when I worked at K-Rock and it got 09?
Put on Moves Like Jagger by Maroon 5.
It absolutely was. It was when...
I could see you hating it. It's when I didn't K-Rock, even think I liked it. Scott in Alabama, we already had Kissed by a Rose.
Mark in Michigan, though.
Ask him why he likes it.
Yeah, Mark in Michigan, do you love the song? Do you love Adam Levine? Do you love Mick Jagger? Are you there, Mark?
Yeah. I'd love to break that Maroon 5 out, Mick Jagger.
Are you Canadian? You're coming with a thick accent.
British.
You're British. All right.
Yeah, I just live in the States now.
And, but so you just loved it because it's, did you just love the song or do you just love Maroon 5?
Yeah, I don't like Maroon 5. No, I think their songs are dreadful for the most part, but, Mick Jagger, is an amazing dancing song. Like, I don't even dance, but like,
it's an amazing, also having a British guy shit on Guilty Pleasures is great because it sounds like more of a review than just trashing. Yeah, this song came...
Crank it up, Lou.
What year did this come out? 2011?
Must have been like three or four years ago.
I feel the same way about that other shitty thing they did. Sugar! You're sweet! I mean, no man's voice should go that high.
But it does.
You know that song I'm talking about? What was it? Was it Sugar? Is that what it's called?
Do you guys remember...
I used to embarrass my daughter with it. I think it's Sugar.
Remember Crazy Town?
Butterfly.
Yeah. I wonder if people are going to get angry or happier with that one. Play that crazy time, which, by the way, it's a stolen Red Hot Chili Peppers guitar lick.
Really?
This isn't it.
No, is this Sugar?
Probably. We don't have to listen to it. We just going to get that chorus, really.
It sounds like a newsroom.
Yeah, here it is. Shifty Shovel Shits, whatever the fuck his name was.
Yeah, no, never mind.
I met him. Now, if you look at them, you'll hate the song all over again.
Yeah.
They are not good to look at to enjoy them. Oh. And by the way, this guy became exactly what you thought. Remember, he was all over like the celebrity rehab shows and shit.
Oh, yeah, no, I don't like this.
It's like Sugar Ray, I Just Want to Fly.
Yeah.
Also, third place would be...
I mean, you want to bring in Third Eye Blind like I'm not a fan?
I mean, this is the best song.
But
ever.
Looking at them, to
I
the
like,
point
I like a lot of Third Eye Blind songs.
Yeah.
Blind.
But looking at them, they're kind of like jizz bags. Like, they kind
of
suck.
Yeah. That's a great way of calling them jizz bags. It's Bob Dylan doing cooking. Bob Dylan doing Third Eye Blind.
Love motivation. Have the same. Yeah, me. Hey,
yeah, if this was a Dylan song, you'd be like, this is genius. Hey.
Jacob's texting me that we should break.
Oh.
Oh, my Christ.
God, Jacob's so mean, Jacob.
Tell him to say it to my face.
He also says,
I'm the only guy who could fuck this girl. Everyone's a fucking faggot.
Wow. Well, I'm not going to fight with a guy who's willing to say shit like that.
Yeah, that's a man with nothing to lose. We'll take a commercial break. We'll be back. It's the Bonfire.
And now, back to the Bonfire with Big J. Oakerson and Dan Soder.
It's been 1 week since you looked at the Bonfire on Comedy Central Radio, Sirius XM 95. We're doing songs that make people angry. I just found out that Omi, one of our loyal listeners, hates Desiree's You Gotta Be, and it upsets me because it's one of my favorite songs. And he loves every song.
And it's, I guess there's certain songs that I definitely fucking, like, I hate. Like, I never want to hear them.
LFO's Summertime Girl is one of those.
Yeah, I wouldn't care if I ever heard that again.
Yeah. Mike Fenoya. Soon to be your former roommate.
Yes.
But currently still.
Currently still my roommate. And, Mike Fenoya had a great one. It's, 10,000 Maniacs, These Are the Days. That is pretty hilarious. Because anything with that Natalie Merchant voice,
yes.
As a dude, you're like, you need 14 tattoos to cover one 10,000 Maniacs song, Love.
Yeah. Oh, dude, that's great. I love the...
Just sweater rock.
Fenoya loving this.
Hey, amigos.
I used to have a crush on her. I'm with him.
Who doesn't?
Natalie Merchant?
Yeah.
Did you really
have a crush on her now still, and she's got gray hair. She stinks.
Hey.
I love her.
You just dug her, huh? Is it because she sort of looks like Eddie Vedder?
Even the way she started that song.
Hang on, beef.
Corn beef.
Performed together, so what?
Yeah. What happened?
Yeah, they've performed together.
Have they?
Yeah.
The Jam and the Maniacs?
A lot of boners.
That's so much boner for you. What was the other one Fenoya said? He had another one, but I feel like I agreed with the other one too much. Oh, no, I don't agree. Everybody hurts, but I'm never in the mood to hear that, ever. Never, ever. Do you ever feel, like, ever?
Nah.
Everybody hurts? It's such a, it's just slow and like, ugh.
Yeah. Oh, Natalie Merchant is beautiful.
Well,
It's the kind of woman you buy a cabin with up in Washington. Settle down with. Let her get gray.
You're damn right, amigo.
I want to see her now. Let me see her with the gray hair.
Get her some super crunchy cabin. You don't think she's hot?
She's interesting looking.
Hey, that's beauty, bud.
No. She looks like maybe like a cute island boy.
I'll take that cute island boy for my adventures.
Can we get a picture of her?
But I'm Natalie Merchant. Lou's helping to pick out, so... Oh, wow. She looks like an old Native American.
Fuck me, running. You're attracted to her now? Exactly.
She goes...
She's a woman to come in and spiritually clean your house.
She goes, I have talked to the spirits. They are angry at what you have brought here. Great disrespect. You cannot put in the pipeline.
Oof, look at some of these pictures.
Dude, come on, Lou. There's no way you're still into her.
Blow a crush on her.
This librarian face?
What am I, a beauty? I'll take her.
Oh, man, she looks like she owns a fucking cafe in Idaho somewhere.
Jesus
looks
Christ.
Like she has a lot of cats.
My husband died.
That picture all the way to the right. No. Yes. I mean, that's rough.
Yeah, that's book club leader. That's Michael Moore.
Oh.
Dude, that is hilarious.
Oh, what a mean thing back and forth to do.
Were they just at the same event?
Nope.
Oh.
They just both they like to both stand in.
Dude, they're at the same event.
Indoor scarves.
Oh, man. All right. Let's get back.
Oh, congratulations.
Lou, I hope
you're old geese.
Lou, I was on your side until the recent pictures came out.
She looks really good there.
Yeah.
But she turned into a fat shaman.
Yeah. Jesus
Christ. Without makeup.
Jesus. Her voice also, I wouldn't find very attractive.
I feel like she'd, I feel like she'd boss you into a specific diet. She's like, we only eat venison on Thursdays.
Yeah, we only eat dragon fruit.
Okay, are you ready for your kombucha?
Very rare.
Yeah, drink this kombucha and I'll blow you by the lake.
Go back to the call screen because you were loving some that we saw on the online there.
Oh, online on Twitter, people were having some fucking great ones. Cotton Eye Joe by Rednecks.
Danny in L.A., I will not take your call because Joe Esposito's "You're the Best Around" is not a guilty pleasure. You're always sort of listening to it for a joke, only because it's just known from Karate Kid. You know what I mean? You can crank that in a car.
Yeah,
and people around you will be like, "That is funny."
No, because it's got the perfect. It's got the perfect nostalgia.
Everyone gets the joke.
Stand by, Jason.
Don't get Jacob around him.
Yeah, goddamn right. We already Alabama. We already had "Seal Kissed by a Rose." We already did.
But Zach Soto coming in hard with "All for One." I swear.
Oh yeah.
And I'll tell you this, that's one of mine.
Yeah.
When it hits you, it hits you.
See, I would go for the. Didn't they also do a cover with Peter Cetera? Is that them?
No.
Of "Hard to Say I'm Sorry." Who was that?
Don't you know this?
I do know this one. But this isn't guilty pleasure for me. I would never roll up a window for this one.
What?
Nah, it wouldn't happen.
You'd skip?
I'd skip. Unless I had three buddies in the car and we were going to four-part
harmonize. Yeah.
Maybe then I'm
That's just
it.
Impressive. But I want in on that friendship.
Who did the "Hard to Say I'm Sorry" cover?
Oh, but listen to how hard they're going on this. They're really trying.
It's already been made fun. It's like the entire beginning of, like, multiple movies where a guy's like singing.
Oh, it's Ryan Reynolds in that Amy Smart movie.
Yeah, "Just Friends."
Yeah.
Now you know my gay pleasure for movies.
Yeah. Okay. Really played your hand there, huh, Jay?
"Just Friends." Saw it a bunch.
I might as well bark up. I'm like Vince Vaughn in "The Breakup." One of the greatest movies. Oh, goddamn it!
"The Breakup" was a great movie. Anything, Christine?
From what?
Who does that cover of "Hard to Say I'm Sorry"?
Can I tell this, John Corley? Tweeted me this, and I think he's right. Creed's "Higher." I watched Burt do it at Legion of Skanks at Skankfest, and I remember that there was a time when I enjoyed the song before everyone dumped on Creed. There was a moment where, like, oh, let's go there, just when it starts.
This wasn't my,
because
I like it with Burt's energy behind it.
Yes, Burt's energy behind it, but really, there is a thing about. It took me a couple years to realize it was shitty, if that makes sense.
Yeah, yeah.
I kind of liked it, and then someone's like, "This is garbage." And I was like, "But what?" And they're like, "Yeah, dude, this sucks." And you're like, right here, where he just starts singing, you're like, "But that's kind of cool, right?" Like, it's the Lane Staley hack.
Yeah. I didn't, no. One song by Creed I liked, called "One."
Yeah.
And I still, that's their only good song to me, and I wouldn't call it a guilty pleasure. I'd crank that.
Oh, shit, New Radicals. Yeah. But I don't know if that's just a good song.
Will You Give?
Yeah.
It's not, yeah, people would hear that and be like, oh, yeah. This is what I was saying, the As Yet song up
I
top
even
there.
I didn't even know this.
Yeah, you do.
But that was Gene Napier.
It's a Chicago cover, but Peter Cetera jumps in.
Dude, I haven't This is more than a guilty pleasure. This is going to be the fucking theme song of 2017 for me. Oh, let me remember. KS107.5 used to play this shit.
To say
Deborah, everybody.
Right here.
From each other.
They all look like they should... They're attractive enough to be in briefs commercials.
Oh, yeah.
This looks like all men that are in briefs ads.
90s perfect beards.
Oh, yeah. Lined up perfectly. Oh, he's so angry.
But the only kind of anger that only a black a cappella group could do?
Yeah. With it's acceptable anger.
Flowy shirt. Oh. Yeah, you're not calling the cops on these guys.
No, you're going like this. I hope he sings this out.
Yeah.
After all that we've been through.
It looks like a young draft class.
It does look like a young... It is funny that, like the 90s black culture based on, like, the most hardcore gangster rap ever.
And
then this.
Oh, just a
and
bunch.
And being, like, a beautiful, pretty black dude. But then they've merged now. Because now it's, like, the hardest core rappers wear the tightest shit.
Yeah, and this was just like when... Oh, look at this.
Kendrick Lamar, they go, Kendrick, you're on a 5. And he has to snap buttons between, like, over his dick.
Hold on. Harness is almost ready.
And let me get my leotard on.
These guys, though, all the music videos look like single sites. Like single
black
website.
Blackpeoplemeetnow.com.
I look like blackpeoplemeetnow.com. Who is he? Get out of here.
Commercials.
Get out of here, Puerto Rican. Oh.
We're waiting. We're all waiting for you to call. Dude, I used to perform at a place called La Bar Bat. It was the after work comedy jam, all black show, and it was like everyone was dressed like this.
Really?
And they'd go, hey, stop mingling. We're going to do a comedy show now. And they fucking hated it.
When does Peter Cetera show up? Is he in the video? It's like the older, wise, white guy that teaches him how to get the pussy.
I'm pretty sure it's a version with Peter Cetera jumps in on it.
Oh, Marcus Silva, you son of a bitch. What a great fucking... Do you remember this? It's not a guilty...
I will know when I hear it, but I don't know if it's guilty pleasure or not.
Hold on. Then Marcus will get to your song, but...
I'm so fascinated by this music video.
At the Bonfire SXM. Oh, you bring her a puppy and your boys that are in an a cappella group.
Yeah, I show up at her house with a puppy.
With, by the way, a Dalmatian. Notoriously mentally insane dogs.
With my entire black a cappella group.
You go, oh, that over there is Leroy. He's on harmony.
This guy goes, hey, motherfuckers, yo, before we hit the mall, yo, you must stop by my girl's house. I'm going to bring that bitch
a
puppy.
We got to go by these girls' house because he bought this Dalmatian and shit.
All right, motherfucker.
All right. All right, can I say something real quick? Your beard is lined up as fuck. Savage Garden is Marcus Silva's. And I'll tell you this, I hated this when this came out, but I get it.
I don't get this one at all still. Never put this on. Because I want to stand by you with it now.
Don't get angry, see? But I'll tell you this is why it's a guilty pleasure. Because how angry you're getting.
No, I don't enjoy one note of it. One note of it. Other people are enjoying it. It doesn't hit me anywhere.
Yeah, that's
whenever you put on Gloria.
Huh?
When you put on Gloria.
I'll fucking flip this table and walk off the show. You're comparing this to Gloria by Laura Branigan?
No, I'm just comparing our emotions.
I'll turn Laura Branigan cranked up windows down in a car any day of the week.
I don't even know that song.
Gloria? Fuck out of here. It just makes Christine think about doing drugs again. That can't be my fucking problem.
Oh, fuck yeah. I know this. Christine, you're broken inside.
Turn it up.
Come on, I want to hear Wayne's in Indiana, because Indiana is a tough place to like this song. Wayne, do you really like this song, or do you like it because it's like funny to laugh at and listen to when it's loud?
Both.
Okay. All right, that's a fucking great, honest answer. Thank you for that. Thank you. Wayne, what is the song?
It was Living La Vida Loca or She Bang by Ricky Martin.
Or She Bang. But if you had to pick one, real Sophie's Choice.
If I had to pick one, it would be Living La Vida Loca, only because of the right before one of my buddies went to boot camp, he decided he was quitting his job by locking himself in the manager's office at a grocery store and singing that as loud as he could through the intercom.
I love it.
Holy shit.
Your friend is an American hero for serving in the military and for doing that at a grocery store.
And that became our go-to get drunk karaoke song whenever we left base and decide
karaoke. Karaoke's well, thanks for serving, dude. And karaoke's a great place for a guilty pleasure because it really solidifies it. That's where came in.
Oh yeah, yeah. Well, I tell you, if you could pull up two songs real quick, we don't have to listen to anything. I'm starting those with what Christine said. There is a bit of a theme to some of my guilty pleasure songs. See if you can feel it. And it's just in the music. And okay. You have Steppin' Out by Joe Jackson. That's a great one.
Don't like it, Christine.
I mean, three songs she's talking about that give her a real problem.
Hold on.
It makes her, like, panicky or something.
Upside, inside, out. Good job, Ricky.
Pull you out.
And that she was so hot in the video, but you knew he was gay. You
knew he was gay. Cherry red and her skin the color mocha.
But I wish she was a dude. Because I'm living a lie. I'm living a big old lie.
Do you have a sister? I like a song that's got a driving, like... Okay, so...
I fucking hate this song.
If we start a business tomorrow, there's no way you hate this song. Say that now, and then tell me you can get through.
Let it build.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, I know what this song is. I'm sorry.
I hate this song.
I just did the beginning.
It's impossible. I say Christine's ridiculous for hating these songs.
Well, Christine is a former drug addict.
Oh, feel it. Feel it, Lou.
That's where... You know, when they did that in the studio, they were like, we got it.
I mean, you have to enjoy this. Alex, you're a young girl. Nothing? She's sort of with it. Blue?
I'm with it.
Christine, I know, hates it. Mike?
Of course.
Dan? Oh. Wait, turn it up. Here's the thing. This made me late for an entire ride to Boston once. Teddy. Ted Busakis. That name, just being the name, made me laugh for an entire drive to Boston. That was fun. Teddy. Ted Busakis. We also found you could plug in Lisa Traeger to that. Lisa Traeger.
Sarah, well, you won't even name that band. I won't even say it on air.
The entire first album was great.
No, you should sit back down. You don't like
it. And the other one is Roxy Music Club, Love is a Drug. And you'll feel, we don't have to play much of that, but just like, really when it comes on, Christine gets like, uncomfortable on her chair.
She starts looking for a razor blade to chop shit up.
Yeah. She goes, anybody got a mirror?
She goes, anybody got a pill? I got an elbow that wants to smash it in the bag. Fucking take it down. Take it down a notch.
I'm excited to take Nick in Pittsburgh, too. Nick, you there?
Nick in Pittsburgh. I don't know if this is a guilty pleasure, dude. I think this is just a good song.
No, it's not.
Yes, it is.
No, this is guilty. You'd have to put your fucking window up for this. Tell them what it is, Nick.
No.
It's Walking on Broken Glass by Annie Lennox.
Yeah, I love it. Dude, I don't think it's a guilty pleasure.
You just love
pleasure.
It outright.
I think it's just a good
You'd
song.
You'd windows down that one.
Yeah, like a motherfucker.
Come on.
Play it? How does it... I'd have to... Yeah. Windows down. Easy.
Really? Like heavy cello in your music?
And if someone looks at me in another car, I'll point right at them.
Give them double metal horns?
Yeah.
Sufi them? What does Jacob think about this song? What's Jacob think of all this, Lou? I guess he has no thoughts.
John Malkovich is
too many fucking faggots in this city.
Yo, buddy.
Do you have the other one I told you to pull up? We have to go here in a second, but I think this one I do. It looks like I still think I wanted to drive a Corvette and do coke in the 80s. All my favorite songs this time. It's Brian Ferry. Roxy Music Group.
Ah, the drummer's great. It's Andy Fury.
This is straight up, let's do fucking blow in a bath.
This is blow, and let's hope my dick can get hard. No comment.
Like, I've done blow in a bathroom listening to this music. There was some just really druggy music we used to listen to.
You weren't around.
Is it weird that their fucking guitar player looks like Zod?
Or young George Carlin?
Before Zod.
Yeah. That's like Zod.
The cars, here in my car really wigs me out.
Anything with talking heads, I want to do blow to. Anything talking heads, I'm always like, I could do some blow to talking heads. And I've never done blow, but I've
always... Psycho killer. I think we've learned a lot about each other today. Look at that dance. Oh, let me feel it, Lou.
Well, if you're in Wilmington, North Carolina, you can catch Big J at the Dead Crow Comedy Club this Friday and Saturday. That's tomorrow and Saturday, so go check them out if you're in Wilmington, North Carolina. And then also July 17th, the three-year anniversary of the SDR show at Exile Bar. That's above 2A in New York City. It's going to be Team Big J versus Team Ralph Sutton for Family Feud with Consequences. Come hang out and celebrate. Show starts at 10, July 17th. Again, that's at Exile Bar for the three-year anniversary of the SDR show. And follow us on Twitter, Instagram, and Facebook at The Bonfire. Fire SXM.
Check out Dan's new special, half-hour special, as part of the series of stand-ups on Netflix now. Check it out. Minneapolis campers, also you can catch Dan at Acme Comedy Club Thursday, July 13th through Saturday, July 15th. Get all your tickets for Dan's shows anywhere in the country at dansoder.com.
It was fun doing a half week with you. We'll be back next week for a full week.
Full week.
4 days of shows, Monday through Thursday.
Jakob's back.
No, he's gone.
Oh, he's back all next week?
He's gone all next week,
ooh,
dude.
So we're Lou's going to be running nuts.
Oh, he's going to be going nuts.
How many days does Lou find an excuse to drink in the studio?
Yeah, I think he gets cashed, and I think he comes in on Thursday even when we're not live.
You know what would be fun, guys?
I'm the only guy who could fuck this girl. Everyone's a fucking faggot.
Oh, I can't argue with that. I'm not going to argue with that, everyone.
Jacob's so angry.
Good night, everyone. We'll catch you next week. It's The Bonfire.